Hey guys, it's Noah Fleming coming back to the LinkedIn audience for another video today to talk about customer experience. So before the pandemic, my wife and I love to travel to New York City. We used to go every summer. In fact, we started taking our kids a couple years ago and it became sort of a family tradition where every summer we would kick off the school getting out. We would literally get on a plane the next day and we'd head to New York. We'd spend a few days there. We'd go see a Broadway show. Now this all started because a couple of years ago, I did work with the Broadway organization, helping them with their customer experience. And you know, one of the things that we loved about New York was we found our favorite hotel, which was in the Central Park area. And this was just a great hotel. They had a really consistent experience. It was always top notch, and we just knew that we could count on this place to have a wonderful time. But what we really loved about this hotel was the doorman. And what was really interesting about them was every time we would return, the same doorman would be there. And they got to know us, they remembered us. They would say, oh, hello, Mr. Fleming, good to see you again. They would remember my kids' names. It was really cool. But in travel, when people talk about the customer experience, it's often said that the doorman is the most important part or the most important person in the customer experience because he or she is often the first person you see or they're the last person you see. So they're the ones that create that first impression or the ones that create that lasting impression. Now, psychology tells us that experiences are often remembered with how they start and how they end. And I talk about this in great detail in my book, The Customer Loyalty Loop. We go into tremendous detail here, but there's examples of where a great hotel experience, often, you know, a 7-day trip that's truly enjoyed, it's a wonderful time, can be ruined by the checkout process and something happening when the client is getting ready to leave. Because that's the memory that sticks. That's the memory that's implanted. So everything else kind of gets erased. So in that book, we talk about different ways to make sure that you're achieving a great start to your experience, a wonderful ending, and then building in these remarkable moments throughout the entire customer experience. But the point is that any employee in your organization today has the potential to be that first point of contact with the customer. And so if they were the first point of contact, or if they were the last point of contact, would they know enough? Would they have enough knowledge? Would they have the skills to create that great first impression or to create that strong lasting impression? So the things you need to consider are, do they know about all of your ongoing sales and marketing promotions? Would they know how to help the customer get support or service if they need it? These are the types of things that you need to know. So it's really simple stuff, but it's stuff that you need to be thinking about. Everybody has the opportunity to be the doorman today. And so you need to make sure that everybody's equipped with the skills to create that strong first impression and that really powerful lasting impression. You know, we talk a lot about missions and values and all of these things. Well, those things are only words. And what we need to make sure is that your people, all of your people, live up to them, because that's what's going to matter during those interactions with your customers. So hit the like button, share this with somebody you think would get value from this video, and I'll see you tomorrow.